feed the text by telling students who Edgar Allan Poe is and what his short story is about. We then read the text together with our students in class. Then we enhance or enliven the text by using the method called virtual filmmaking. Then we read the text again, this time enjoying it more. Let us look at how one teacher uses the virtual filmmaking method to teach the short story.
Okay, so this is what you are going to do today with your group members. You are going to come up with a poster, a movie ad or a print ad. Have you seen a print ad?
Yes, ma'am.
Of a movie?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. To give you an idea of what its equivalent is, on TV or even when you watch movies, you watch also trailers of movies that are going to be shown in the near future, okay? You are shown trailers. But more often, you also see print ads or movie ads which you find in pages of newspapers or even magazines advertising the movie. That is what you are going to come up with, okay? First, think of the title of the movie. You can use other titles, huh? Not exactly the title given there, but the story should be based on the story itself, okay? After thinking of the title, you can think of the cast, the actors who can play the role, the roles of those two characters in our story. You choose whether local or Hollywood actors, okay? And think of the genre of the movie that you are going to produce. And also don't forget to think of the production name that you have or you want. Production name or company name that you want to include there in the credits. Produced by, okay. Directed by, who will be the director, okay? And you write there the cast names. Can you do that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's begin. Here are the materials for you to use. Okay, of course, before you begin, you have to discuss first with your members the concept. Now you are through with your masterpieces. Okay, you will post your works there on the board. There are three areas there. Post your works now. Plenty of tape so that it will pull. Okay, who is now ready to explain? This group?
So are you ready for a great movie experience? Then watch The 12th Thief, adapted from the short story, The Casa Montegallo. The 12th Thief in Pace Requiescat, or Rest in Peace, is a story about a man who wants to take revenge on another man because of an insult. Leading actors, Johnny Depp as Montresor and Jim Carrey as Fortunato. We chose Johnny Depp as Montresor because Johnny Depp is very eccentric and he has a lot of roles in suspense thrillers. We also chose Jim Carrey as Fortunato because he's very foolish and also, one of his weaknesses is pride in some of his films. And this movie was made by the excellent company, and so it is an excellent production. And because of Mel Gibson's great directing skills in morbid films, like, and in very touching films like The Passion of the Christ, we decided that the director should be Mel Gibson. So sit back, relax, and wait for the coming of The 12th Year, coming in theaters on June 2010.
Okay,
Edgar Allan Poe's The Cask of Amontillado, it highlights the eerie effect of catacombs in your life. Now, of course, it's made by Ace Company, so of course it's an Ace production. It is a Steven Spielberg film, which in, he's not a Steven Spielberg, the famous one, he's another one, unknown. So featuring Steve Carell as Montresor, because he looks as if he's clever, yet his looks can easily deceive you. And Jim Carrey, Jim Carrey as the Fortunato, because he can easily be deceived. Now this will show May 2009.
Come on, come all. This is Ultimate Carnival Experience this summer. Cheers to them. This is a film by Hota 5 Productions, directed by Tim Burton. It shows Tim Burton because of his... you can see that in his films, there is an eerie theme and also the gloomy theme, like The Nightmare Before Christmas, Corpse Bride, and other films. Contradictory to the other we chose Johnny Depp as our Fortunato because, as you all know, Johnny Depp is a very versatile actor, and as Captain Jack Sparrow in the trilogy Pirates of the Caribbean, he is a drunkard and he is also very goofy. As our Montresor, we chose Antonio Banderas because he's a sly and cunning and he looks very clever and serious in his roles. And we also added another character because we decided our film to be a mystery and detective story, and he is Keanu Reeves. And we chose this picture because this one symbolizes, of course, the hat of Fortunato, and this one is the broken bottle of wine, but instead of wine, we replaced it with blood, which depicts the violence that is shown in the film.
This is the way to teach the short story using virtual filmmaking.
The virtual filmmaking method consists of asking students to pretend that they are making a movie. The students are asked to invent a title appropriate to the story, to choose real-life actors to portray the characters in the story, and to decide the genre of the film. The method is good because, first, it forces the students to read the story closely in order to get to know its setting, plot, and characters. Second, it allows students to use their visual imagination. And third, it brings a story closer to the modern world, thus making it interesting to them.
Shit for a walk in the woods.
The Blair Witch Hunt provides all amenities while you risk certain death and dismemberment.
Give it up.
What's up with all this camera stuff?
To record all occult phenomena that may manifest itself in the course of the tour.
Damn.
There are other methods of teaching the short story. What we have done in today's lesson is to show the teacher how to use virtual filmmaking.
Much further. A couple more miles.
Jesus. So how far along are you? What do you mean? The baby. How many weeks?
6.
You don't want to keep it, do you?
No.
But Steven wants the baby.
Yes. How do you know?
I don't know. So what are you going to do?
I don't know.
What do you need all these cameras for?
I am personally hoping for an Ellie Kedward sighting. I got a big beta for a quality master, I got a night vision, I got an infrared, I got a cute little mini DV, I got handhelds for everyone, and this little baby can even do frame a second time lapse. So if anything comes in for a quick visit, we're gonna catch it.
May I have permission to take this leaf?
Thank you.
evil intent in the ground, may your release soon be found. In peace, release the energy that be for my magic. So mote it be, evil intent in the ground, may your release soon be found. In peace, release the energy that be for my magic. So mote it be.
This is Isagani Cruz, inviting you to watch other lessons in the series Telecourse for teachers and students of literature.
Lend a helping hand, use, provide you teaching tools, points you to the path to improve in all our schools, English, science, math. Let's upgrade the standard of our education.
Oh.